For years, the electoral war over electricity supply in Delhi has been a rather crucial factor for political parties. The issue of power tariff hinges on sentiments of over 70% of the low and middle income groups and a growing migrant population in the city who are trying to save every penny in their electricity bills, at least. As parties promise huge power subsidies ahead of polls, Miranao's Apoorva Shridhar tries to find out its impact on the voters' mind.
48-year-old Om Prakash is an auto rickshaw driver whose family migrated from Rajasthan's Dausa around 50 years ago. Living in his own 200 square feet accommodation, he's the sole breadwinner supporting a family of five. As he calculates his monthly expenses, he's relieved looking at his electricity bill.
Bijli pe farak pada hai. Bahut had tak farak pada hai. Isme 500 rupaya tak ka hua hai ki hamara bach jata hai. उससे यह है कि और चीज महंगी हो रही है वो वहां रेस्ट हो रहा है
अगर हम 200-300 रुपए बच रहे तो हमें दो दिन का खर्चा निकलता उससे घर का मतलब बचत जो होती है तो बच्चों की पढ़ाई पे लगाते हैं ट्यूशन पे लगाते हैं किसी भी चीज पे लगाते हैं
लाइक ओम प्रकाश देयर आर ओवर 40,000 माइग्रेंट्स मोस्टली फ्रॉम उत्तर प्रदेश बिहार एंड राजस्थान लिविंग इन टिगरी कॉलोनी अ लो इनकम नेबरहुड इन साउथ दिल्ली With zero power tariff up to 200 units, the cost of electricity has become a key electoral issue.
For many years, the political fight over electricity has been hugely significant in attracting the low-income groups and 40% migrant population. Now, as Delhi heads to polls, the price sensitivity of people from the lower strata will be an important factor.
But not everyone is impressed. The daily wagers say that they do not receive the full benefit of the electricity bill waiver. This is because a majority of house owners charge their tenants by installing an electricity sub-meter that would reflect the exact amount of power consumed by each tenant.
हमको तो कोई फर्क नहीं है। हमको तो भाई किराये पे देन जितने यूनिट गिरेगा उतना देना है।
मुनाफा अभी तक तो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ा हमें। अभी कोई ऐसी नौबत नहीं आई है। पहले 500-600 आते थे, अब जाके 200-250 कभी कल 150 भी आ जाता है इस पीरियड लेकिन अब जो गर्मी आएगी वो पैसा बढ़ जाता है
जस्ट 6 किलोमीटर्स अवे द स्टोरी इज नो डिफरेंट होम टू ओवर 45,000 लो एंड मिडिल इनकम वोटर्स पुल प्रहलादपुर इन साउथ ईस्ट दिल्ली इज डोमिनेटेड बाय कंस्ट्रक्शन लेबरर्स स्मॉल स्केल ट्रेडर्स एंड फैक्ट्री वर्कर्स द टेनेंट्स क्लेम दैट दे हैव टू पे द बिल व्हाइल लैंडलॉर्ड्स एक्सप्लॉइट द पावर बिल वेवर
फर्क पड़ने वाली बात जहाँ तक ये है कि हमको तो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता मगर मकान मालिक को फर्क पड़ता है हम पहले भी 7 रुपये रीडिंग दे रहे थे और आज भी हम 7 रुपये रीडिंग दे रहे हैं मकान मालिक छोटे छोटे मीटर मार्केट से ला के हर कमरे में ठोक रखा है
Over the years, the high electricity bills have led to growing discontent among low-income voters. While political parties try to outdo each other with poll swaps, 60% of Delhi's resettlement colonies and rapidly growing migrant population could play a decisive role in the upcoming polls.
Electricity has always been a factor in Delhi as a state. Over the years, while power privatization may have removed the problems of supply network, the cost of electricity has become a talking point in elections because of the nature of people who live here. With video journalist Mohan Singh, this is Apoorva Shridhar in New Delhi for Mirror Now.
And now let's get you some quick updates around the Delhi elections. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal held a roadshow earlier today at the Timarpur area. This is part of a series of roadshows that he has held ahead of the 8th February assembly polls. Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad has said that the government is ready to speak to protesters in Shaheen Bagh if he gets a structured request. His comment came while speaking to a media organization. The Election Commission has issued a notice to BJP General Secretary Arun Singh over the advertisement poster which read 15 saal Congress ki loot, 5 saal aap ki jhoot. The EC is of the view that the poster violates the model code of conduct. It has given the BJP time till noon on the 31st of January to submit a response after a complaint was filed in this regard by the Congress party. Delhi Police's Anti-Corruption Department has registered an FIR against AAP MLA and Okhla candidate Amanatullah Khan. As per sources, the FIR has been registered under the Prevention of Corruption Act. K. case against Amanatullah Khan pertains to alleged irregularities in Waqf Board recruitment. He is accused of misusing the funds allocated by the government to the Waqf Board.